and tell your friends that this match is going down because it should be a fantastic competition. I mean, this is essentially the matchup that should have been streamed ages ago. Evil Geniuses versus Who Run It.
Yeah, out of the hundreds of times they've played, we haven't been able to stream them yet, so this should be definitely a good view for anybody watching right now.
Yeah. Well, this is definitely going to be a very exciting match, especially if you were tuning into any of the Quake Live coverage at all. That there's a lot of, it's almost going to be a grudge match, so we'll see how it goes.
Do we have any particular predictions from our fellow staffers here?
Well, that really depends on how well, I'm sure EG is full into mode, and I'm sure Who Run It is as well. You know, especially with QuakeCon, this match being so soon after QuakeCon, there's still a lot of high energy, so we're going to be seeing both teams playing, you know, at a very good pace, and these guys are going to be on top of their games, of course. And just out of curiosity, do we have a map list for tonight, or is it going to be picked on a match-by-match basis?
Yeah, the OSCE rules, I think, is one team just picks the first map, and the second team picks, the other team picks the second map, and then I think if they split, I think the team with the highest total caps from the two maps picks the third map.
Yeah, everyone, make sure to check out the Tasty Spleen Tasty Cast. Jahar does is it a weekly podcast or semi-weekly?
Oh, we do all sorts of stuff. We have news, we have map reviews, we have community events, we cover all that. Currently, the process is getting the video stream up. We have a map, but a faulty capture card has been plugging that up for the past week. Otherwise, we would be having the Onage Quake World Tournament going on right now, the Z-Daemon Duel League going on right now, and the Euro Q2 League with Puri and a lot of other familiar faces currently in signups. So we're slated for all three of those leagues, and I just need to get a brand new capture card that won't crash my system. I would feel free to use this setup to broadcast some QLTV stuff too. So who knows? Maybe you can have a night off sometime.
Oh my God! Don't tease me, you dirty man.
I still got my pants on too.
Oh jeez, that is young. All right, let the game window commence. All right. So it looks like the first map that we're gonna see is gonna be. What was that?
Oh, I'm just trying to fit in here.
That's what you said? I don't know. Sorry. Okay.
All right. That's the best way to do it when Greece is here.
Alright, so yeah, we're going to see... what the fuck is the map? Siberia, Jesus Christ. We're gonna play some Quake tonight. Here we go. And we're starting to see the radios. Okay, so if this is spot here in the center, this is where the quad spawns. And I'm going to go hopping over to somebody's point of view. And catch somebody in the base. There we go. Okay, so there's yellow armor back here behind the flag. The flag spawns in this area here. We have mega health. So these are resources that are usually left behind for the main defender. Over here is where we can find the red armor. Now, the blue base looks exactly like this. And one of the key things that you'll find is a railgun here on your way out towards the center of the map. So the normal flag runs you're going to see, the low route is through this long hallway here. Actually, the fastest route is through red armor and then down underneath the medkit area here where KGB just happened out. And that gets you straight out to the center of the map. So. I think we were just teased with these F3s. I've been trying to rush through this because I thought maybe they would actually ready up. Alright, I have a job for my fellow QLTV staffers. And that is to track the capture times tonight. Because I wanna see if we can keep track of the fastest capture time.
Sounds good. And do we have a special complimentary package for said capper, or do we just give them a virtual pat on the back?
It'll be something special.
A special package coming from Greece. Oh yeah.
My package is always special.
You just walk into these things way too much. Alright. Well, all of EG is F3'd up. We're just waiting on KGB. Is he having any problems right now, or is this just Oh, there we go. Cool. We have the countdown. EG versus Who Run It. Siberia is our first map, and we're about to go underway.
All right, so we got MSRD. We're going to try to figure out who's going to be playing what positions. I have a feeling that EG is going to change up their typical lineup a little bit here. We got ID missing the first run. We got Mr. SD about to come through and grab the flag here. He's coming up through the back. Typo K is the man on defense for EG, and he always does a tremendous job. He's quite impressive on the defense. Now we do. I'm gonna hop over, see if I can get over to ID here. There we go. He goes down. We got KGB and ID killing themselves. So no luck there. Mr. SD goes down one more time. Nice rail by ID.
ID, he's right around the corner. Very nice.
So yeah, we're getting the first clear for the first.
Oh shit!
We have a timeout. Not sure why.
Now would be a great time. Yeah.
Prepare to fight. 3, 2, 1.
Alright, looks like we're back in here. ID really raping that up. Clamp grabbing the quad, missing that first rail, heading back now, and this is vital because, you know, the main thing right now is not to let the other team have the quad. Sure, you can do a lot of good by running in, but with only 32 health and a handful of armor, Clamp really realizes that either A, he's got to stack up before going in with the quad, or just chill out and make sure that that Who Run doesn't get it.
Yeah, and use it defensively,
awesome,
which you just did
at the same time.
Yeah, and so yeah, that first quad going to EG, and we'll have to keep track and see which team gets more quads tonight, but so far so good for EG. I'm going to watch Clamp a little bit on D, because he's always extremely strong in this particular position. He's currently stacking up, although his stack is a bit low.
Yeah, when you're doing public CTF matches, it's hard at first to grasp the concept of playing a defensive role instead of just, you know, spawning, grabbing a weapon and heading out for the flag. But these roles, especially in a professional atmosphere, very vital. And especially if you have the quad, helps out a hell of a lot.
Here's
Dang,
the first flag
got the
touch.
Flag. No, he doesn't.
Yeah, ID's got it though, and he's full 100-100. Here he goes. He's on the run, and he's been spotted by an LG. The LG tears him apart, along with an MG from Swooped, and that will destroy that first flag run. We got 30 seconds of the next squad, and we've got ID getting out to the middle of the setup for it. No, he wants to do a flag run first. He has a med kit. We're going to watch it.
That med kit burned through way too quick. He's only going in with a handful of health, and one rail from Swooped is going to take him down a notch, and any chance he had of getting the flag there, sorry, bro.
What a mate.
We're seeing a little bit more nail gun usage now that the nail gun speed has been ramped up. I like that.
Here it is. Here's the quad. It is immediately destroyed. It is still out there ready to be taken. It's picked up by Clamp. Clamp once more going to take it on D. Oh, look at this. We're about to see
raping
it.
Oh,
pick
this
it up.
Is bad. He's got a good
going back to grab that
just grab the yellow
armor, and this is it. This is a quad run with the flag. Oh, nice work there.
Wow, and now Mr. SD has the flag, heading out. Still got a few seconds left on the quad, but no. To grunts say no.
The GWC and DeHang team up there to make sure that the quad carrier does not get anywhere.
Oh, for fuck's sake. DeHang is definitely full of spunk tonight.
Prepare to fight. 3, 2, 1, fight.
All right, we're back underway.